Welcome back. Please take your seats. It's time to start Act Two.
Which way did he go?
I think he went this way.
That way!
To summarise, the bad guy's gone and Kat's in a to-do. The drama group is about to meet and rehearse an age-old scene. So we cast our eyes to Isabella's group, who are also very keen.
Thank you. Okay, everybody, are we all ready to go over the shepherd scene? Ready and action!
Golly, it's cold outside. I wonder if those sheep have those nice woolly coats.
Yeah, the sky is really clear.
Bah.
Look at that really bright star.
Is that what makes the scene so bright? Look!
Bah.
What's that?
Behold! Bah. I bring you! Talks about the star being so bright, so I thought a torch would help.
Let's ask the audience for their help. Yeah. Can all you girls and boys out there with your torches, can you put them up in the air and give them a twirl? Excellent, well done. We're making it really bright. And we're going to sing a song about a star.
Managed to get reprogramming indeed, I'll show them. Think they can outsmart me? I'm bad and there's nothing that can be done about it. I was born bad, then I'll die bad. I can't help it, it's genetic. Ooh, better hide. You better not tell them where I am because I'm really, really bad. And now I shall make myself disappear. You can't see me!
Oh, yes, we can!
Oh, no, you can't!
Oh, yes, we can!
Oh, no, you can't!
Oh, yes, we can!
Can't! Can't!
Can't!
Can't! Can't! Can't! Can! No! Don't make me come down there. Right. You can't see me.
Yes,
you can. Doggy poo. Nah, the perfect place.
Well, they can't have got that far. We haven't got to it yet. Wait a minute. They must be around here somewhere. We're still not there. Wait a minute.
Well, if I were a really bad guy, I'd hide in that box.
That is why you're not a really bad guy, Norman. That is far too obvious. No, he'll be hiding in somewhere that we wouldn't suspect. Somewhere like... here? I give you Natas! I'm all out of ideas. What about you, Cap?
Well, we know that Natas is hiding around here somewhere, but we need the element of surprise. So, we need you to whisper really quietly where he is hiding. Do you think you can do that?
Yes!
I said, do you think you can do that?
Yes!
Should we have a...
Try saying supercalifragilisticexpialidocious really quietly.
Okay, you're a bit on the loud side. So, what we'll try, we will point to hiding places where he could be, and we need you to shake your head no, or nod your head yes, and then we can have the element of surprise. Let's have a go, shall we? Good work, everyone. Right, Natas and RC, we know you're in there. Come out! You are sure he went in there, aren't you?
Yes!
Norman, tip it over!
Hey, he's not in here. Are you trying to trick us?
No, I am! Did you really think you could catch me?
Quick, he's escaped! After him!
Natas! Natas! Where's he got to? I've told you lot, shut up! Right. He's forgotten his lunch and I need to give it to him. It's special. I made it myself. Ha ha! Bet you can't guess what's in it. Well, for a start off, he's got a carton of slug juice. Now, it's an old family recipe. My sister, Heather, she's a witch over in Eastbourne. You take one cup of slugs. I don't know why I'm telling you, like, it's a family recipe. It's a secret. He wants to get rid of me, I think, you know. And it's really lovely. So, I don't know if there's any young men out there who, you know, because... I'm all woman. No? Oh, all right then. Now then, did you see where he went?
Yes.
Just a minute, just a little minute. Can't see it. Now then, who eats chocolates and sweeties before they go to bed? Put your hand up.
Yay.
I like you because you're naughty. Okay, goody goodies. Who cleans the teeth before they go to bed? Who is it? You do. Right, you tell me. I can't see you, I can see you. You tell me which way did he go?
That way.
That way, right, top, thank you very much. You got sweeties there? No. Hello, darling. Oh, it's lovely. You got sweeties? Who's your parents? Where are they? Why didn't you buy them sweets? Look that tight. Hello, gorgeous. Oh! And there's another fancier old one. Hello, darling. Have you got sweets?
Oh, yeah, Mary. 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 Oh, yeah.
Bobette?
Oh, yeah?
What are you doing here?
I'm just getting into character. I'm just trying to learn some of my moves. Oh, yeah, Mary. I've got this song as well. I can't do it all.
Shall I help you?
Yeah, I don't know whether you'll know the song, though.
I'm sure I do.
Oh. Looks like you do as well.
How does it go?
It goes a little bit like this. I've never wronged an onion.
I hope I never shall. I've never wronged an onion. I'll treat it as a pal. Tell me, tell me, tell me why that's the one I've never wronged an onion. Why should it make me cry?
You know it then.
I always do.
Yeah, all right. Well, do you think, what do you think? Any good?
No, not very good.
What do you mean no?
It wasn't, it was rubbish. Don't you think it was a bit rubbish?
Yeah! Oh, what do you think you could do better then?
Yeah!
Oh, well, we'll see about that, because we're going to need your hand for this one.
Do you think you could do a better job? Because we've got the words here. You can sing along with us.
Wow, well, let's give it a go.
I've never wronged an onion. I hope I never shall. I've never wronged an onion. I'll treat it as a pal. Tell me, tell me, tell me why I've never wronged an onion.
Why should it make me cry? Top with it, you know. It's only a song, isn't it?
There's still an issue here.
What?
It's
what?
Still rubbish.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
I think we need a little bit more help. And conveniently, I think we have some children to help us.
Well, that'd be good, wouldn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
What's that then? What's a children?
Children! The convenient children! Where are you? Pantomime, fun.
Is there, maybe an Auntie Ruth in the house that can help us.
Auntie Ruth, you're in the house, children.
Or see someone darting around at the back there. Hello.
We need to give her a little shout.
Right,
children.
Shall we give it a go? Shall we shout Auntie Ruth and see if we can get... Can you help us with this one? Because it's a little bit tricky. Okay, you ready? 3, 2, 1. Auntie Ruth! Okay, let's try again. It's obviously not loud enough. We're going to try another time. You ready? 3, 2, 1, Auntie Ruth! I think it's working. I think it's working. It's because I can see her walking around collecting children. So it must be working. Aww.
Give
him
a big clap, everyone.
Very good.
Thanks, girls.
Do you
want to get ready? Thank you for your help.
That's all right.
Oh, hello. Welcome on the stage. Come on. Hello. Hello there. Wow. Come and stand by me. I love this Batman t-shirt and you've got a nice big love heart. And is that a monkey on there? And you love Hastings Pier. That's what we like to hear. So face the crowd. They're not that scary. They're not as scary as Natas.
What's your name? Can you speak into it and tell everyone what your name is?
Ben.
Ben. Can we give a big round of applause for Ben?
Wow. Great name.
Oh,
round
of applause for Abby.
What's your name?
Charlie. Oh, wow.
That's
good to know,
now,
isn't it?
Can you give us a little hand and help us sing this song?
Well, they've only got little hands.
Because we've tried, the mums and dads have tried, and it's just not good enough. We needed you to help us. Do you think you can help us? Brilliant! Shall we give it a go?
Oh, excellent.
Come on, ready?
Are you ready?
I've never wronged an onion. I hope I never shall. I've never wronged an onion. I'll treat it as a pal.
That's it.
Tell me, tell me, tell me why I've never wronged an onion. Why should it make me cry?
Oh, very good. Good. We had some lovely bobbing then. Very good bobbing there in time, so it's good.
I think that was the best time ever.
Well, it was better than the other times,
well,
wasn't it?
Well, definitely, because it was just you singing on your own.
Oh, beautiful.
Right. Should we have something special for the 90 room?
Oh, I hope so.
Brilliant. Thank you very much.
Don't we all get one?
No.
Oh.
Right. Here you go, Mummy.
There's one for you. Do you want to go find Auntie
Ruth?
Very good. Give him a big clap.
Wow.
And here's one for
you. Oh, round of applause. Very good. Very good. Very good.
Oh!
Who's this here?
Charlie.
Charlie! What happened, Charlie?
What's happened?
Didn't bring me one.
You didn't bring
me one?
Oh, well, I tell you what, because you were so patient, we might have to give you something special.
Some extra special.
Okay.
What's Auntie Ray got for you?
Round of applause. Very good. We'll give them a round of applause. You can come and collect your children for a small fee afterwards if you want them back again. Or you can pay us even more and we'll keep them.
Bobby, yeah. I think they've had enough of us now.
Okay, well, they've had enough of you. Come on, should we go?
Yeah.
We need to practice our lines. I am Mary! I am Mary! I am Mary! I am Mary! Thank you.
Let's go over the wise men scene. Are you all ready? Action!
We three kings of warrior and tar, bearing gifts to travel so far.
Do it again, with a bit more energy and enthusiasm. And don't forget to smile. Ready? Action!
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts to travel so far. Feel the mountains more.
Shut up! We need some help.
Do you think our friends out here could help us?
That's a lovely idea.
Shall I ask them?
Yes.
Would you mind giving us a hand with this? Yeah. I said, would you mind giving us a hand with this?
Yeah.
Oh, come on, let's do it.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we travel so far.
I think we're making wonderful progress with our play. Yeah. Thanks again for your input.
Oh, it's nothing. I feel I'm really getting to know Mary and what it took for her to go through what she went through. It's just I think I would do so much better if I had a real baby instead of this.
But you, as the artist, must make the audience believe it's a real baby. And someone like you can easily do that.
Maybe. You sure there isn't anyone willing to lend me their baby for this play?
No!
Oh well, we'll try our best. Bye, Isabella. Mwah. Thank you. See ya.
Come along.
Nice to see
you.
Bye!
Nice to see ya.
Bye!
Come on! Bobby, I'll be glad when this is over. It's tortuous.
But Steve, it's all about the process.
My name is not Steve and stuff the process. Look, all I want to do is do my bit and go home. I hope his miserableness appreciates this.
I'm not going anywhere.
What are you talking about? Have you gone mad?
No, I think I've finally come to my senses. I'm sick of being yelled at and put down all the time. I'm tired of always trying to think of bad things to do and being glad when others are hurting. I've had enough.
But you are a bad guy. You were born bad and it's in your genes.
I know, but I don't believe in that anymore. I just want to have some fun.
Boss isn't going to be happy when he hears about this. Mutiny is not allowed.
Bubble, the boss doesn't care about me or you. He only cares about himself and I wouldn't be surprised if this was another one of those silly plans where me and you end up looking like fools.
Of course the boss cares about us. We are his friends. Everybody needs friends, even bad guys. And I will always be your friend. Aww. If you're ever in a jam, here I am. If you're ever in a mess, S-O-S. If you ever feel so happy you land in jail, I'm your bail.
It's friendship, friendship, just the perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgot, ours will still be hot. La-da-la-da-da-da-dee-dee-dee. If you're ever up a tree,
phone to me.
If you're ever down a well,
ring my bell.
If you're ever out to chill, I don't fish teeth.
Oh, I'm on.
It's friendship, friendship, just a perfect friendship. When other friendships have been forgot, ours will still be hot. La 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 la, ding ding ding.
Yeah! bailout. You'll upset him.
Life is full of disappointments, so get used to it.
Oh, my arches are killing me because I'm an archangel. Get it? Archangel? Oh, well, I think it's all this standing around speaking my lines. And I still haven't got that jam roll I was promised. This acting lark is not all it's cracked up to be. I have enjoyed the singing, though I must say I am a little confused with one of my songs. Here, listen to this, and perhaps you can help. Oh, little town of Hastings, so still in the sun's hot rays. You'll get to Bexhill quicker in a car when the bypass is built one day. Oh, doesn't sound right, does it? What do you think? Does it sound right? I think what we should do is have a little sing-along, and you can sing the words back to me in the correct words, and then I might understand. That was wonderful, thank you. And it makes much more sense now. I've been learning my lines as well. Oh, I must practice them, and you can tell me what you think. Do not be afraid, for I bring great news. For in this town, a savior is born. And you will call him Jesus. What do you think? Pretty good, eh? Not bad, eh? Don't understand what it means, though. I wonder whether I should change it a bit so that people can understand it a bit better. No point in saying stuff if no one understands what you're going on about. Come to think of it, I don't really understand what anyone says. Perhaps I should get with that wonderful Bobby. What a treasure she is. And we can rewrite the whole thing. What a wonderful idea. Thank you so much for your help. You've been absolutely wonderful. No, oh, just the person I was looking for. I've been thinking about the play, and what I've realised is that we need to update it a little bit. So what I thought is, if we could get our heads together, maybe we could come up with some ideas.
If you two put your heads together, who knows, you might come up with half a brain.
Oh, just ignore him. He's got issues.
Oh, bless you. Oh, yes, he does seem to have his problems, doesn't he? Yeah. What do you think, then? Shall we give it a go?
Well, shall we ask Mrs. Isabella first? Shall we check with her?
Oh, she's not really with it at the moment. She's a bit over the top about this play. Can't see the trees from the forest, if you know what I mean. No, what I thought we'd do is we'd get some ideas together, and then we'd show at the next reversal. Shall we give it a go, then? Oh! Sorry. Girls only for this one.
I think she's got girls mixed up with hags. I've had enough of this. I'm sick of the Nativity. What a load of rubbish. King born in a stable.
Shepherds bringing little sheep.
Wise men following stars. Give me a break. Now I can see why the boss wants to stop this place from going ahead. Well, I'm all for that. From now on, I will be the worst ever Joseph. And Squeaker better be the worst ever Mary, or else. Think I'll give the boss a ring, see how much longer he wants us to keep this up.
Not now!
But I just wanted to. Hello? Oh, grizzle guts. I must have got cut off. I'll try him again. That's funny, he's not answering. I can hear his phone ringing. What is that ringing? Maybe I've got tinnitus.
You have something far more serious if you don't switch that phone off and help me hide.
Oh, there you are. I just wanted to ask. Hide, yes. Oh, how about a disguise?
Hello, citizens.
Hello, my name's Bub, Steve, and this is Joseph, Joe.
Hello, Bub, Steve and Joe. Going to a fancy dress, huh?
Yes, he's going as Joseph and Mary. Well, just Joseph, actually.
Oh, good. We were wondering if you could help us. We're looking for a bad, nasty villain. Have you seen anyone come this way?
No, perhaps he went that way.
Oh, no, he couldn't have gone that way, Citizen Bub, because we've just come from there.
Are you sure you didn't see anyone?
That must mean he is around here somewhere.
He's not there!
Cat's right. He must be here somewhere.
Not necessarily. Look! You're not here.
Oh, don't be daft. Of course I'm here.
I bet you £10 that you're not here.
All right then. Here's my £10. Hold it for me, will you, Cat? This is going to be the easiest £10 I've ever made. I'm me, and I'm here. Go on then, prove I'm not here.
Are you in Bexhill?
No.
Are you in Eastbourne?
No.
Well, if you're not in Bexhill and you're not in Eastbourne, then you must be somewhere else.
Well, yes, that's right.
And if you're somewhere else, then you can't be here.
I bet you £10 I can prove you're not here.
All right then. Here's my £10. Hold it, will you, Cat?
This is going to be the easiest £10 I've ever made. I'm here and I'm me.
Go on then, prove that I'm not here.
Are you in Bexhill?
No.
Are you in Eastbourne?
No.
If you're not in Bexhill and you're not in Eastbourne, you must be somewhere else.
Yes, that's right.
And if you're somewhere else, you can't be here. Hey, that's my money. Give that back. I won that fair and square.
If I'm not here, I can't have taken it.
Oh, I am bad.
Well, did you see anybody come this way?
A bad, nasty villain, you said. About so high? Dark hair? Looks like this guy. Ow! But that's not him, because this is Joe, and the fella you want went that away.
Thank you, Citizen Buff. You have aided in thwarting a criminal, and if not for you...
Oh, come on!
Right. That's got rid of them. I'm off.
Hang on, boss. I just wanted to ask you...
Oh, for goodness sake! Questions, questions! Can't you work it out for yourself?
Not really. It's about this assignment. How much longer do we have to keep going?
Until it's finished, idiots.
It's just that I'm concerned about Squeak.
Concerned? Concerned? What kind of talk is this from a bad guy? You shouldn't be concerned about anyone. Only yourself. That's what being a bad guy is all about. You only care about yourself.
Yeah, none of those good guys.
No one! Do you think I reached the pinnacle of badness by caring for others? I don't care about you. And I don't care about that imbecile Squeak. No one! And the sooner you realize that, the easier your life will be. Now, I'm off. So long, sucker. And welcome to the big, bad world!
Smile when your heart is aching. Smile even though it's breaking. Though a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile.
Where's your friend gone? You know, the guy that was with you. Joe.
Oh, he went that way. Oh. Can I ask you guys a question?
Sure. What is it?
Do you guys care about each other? I mean, if one of you was in trouble, would the others care? Oh, don't worry. That sounds silly. Forget it.
No, that's a good question. And the answer is yes. Of course we always try to help each other out when we're in trouble. And of course we care. Why'd you ask?
No reason, just wondering.
Well, we've got to go now and find Natas.
Wait, that fella you're looking for, Natas the Nasty. He went that way.
Oh. Come on, thank you.
There's something very wrong about not caring for others. I think I've just learnt an important lesson.
Oi! You! Booble, isn't it? Where's my Natas?
No, madam, it isn't Booble, it's Bubble.
Whatever, just tell me where my Natas is, will you?
You're made from that same uncaring mould as he is, aren't you?
What are you rabbiting on about, drosshead?
See? By belittling others, it makes you feel better. Well, it doesn't work. I've had enough.
Listen. I'll say this slowly so that you understand. Natas has forgotten his lunch. I need to find him to give it to him. Okay?
You want to give Natas his lunch because you really care? Oh, no, Med, you have proved me wrong.
Care about him? Care about him? Oh, well, I don't know what you're rubbing on about. I'll put cyanide in his sandwiches and I need to give it to him, okay?
Maybe Natas is right. You can't change really bad guys. He went that way.
Tough.
But I know it's not too late for me to change.